Welcome back. I'm Gregg Bissonette. We're talking about playing jazz. And this is our jazz curriculum, general jazz classes here. I've spoken already about the quarter note being the most important to me. Anyway, this is all, you can talk to 10 different drummers and get 10 different opinions. It's like, you've got to play traditional grip. You've got to play mashed. You've got to keep a space here. No, don't keep a space here. Use fingers here. There's as many different ways to play jazz as there are play rock, play Dixieland, play songo from Cuba or sambas from Brazil, or to play prog rock, or to play double bass, or to play reggae from Jamaica, or punk rock. There are as many different opinions as there are different grooves. So this is just my opinion. I want to say that right off the bat. One of the things I like to do is play a lot of different styles of music. And vocabulary is key to me. And these are not etched in stone. These are my opinion. But I want to talk right now about something called spang, spang-a-lang. This is kind of the international jazz terminology. And drummers all over the world, no matter if they're speaking Japanese or Korean or German or Spanish or any language, they'll know what spang, spang-a-lang means. And it's basically a quarter note and then a triplet with the middle triplet missing. In the Jim Chapin book, it's written as dotted eighth connected to a 16th note. And then it's told to you in jazz in America, in junior high jazz band and high school jazz band, when you see quarter note, two eighth notes, quarter note, you play that like a triplet. Da, 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 or spang, spang-a-lang. No matter how you write it, it shouldn't feel like da, da, ka, da, da, ka-da, and it shouldn't feel like da, 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 da. It should feel like it sounds. Spang, spang-a-lang, spang-a-lang, spang-a-lang. And that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm not even going to play my hi-hat. I'm going to play spang, spang-a-lang at a slow tempo. And I'm going to try to make it feel like a triplet. Because to me, it's all about the triplet. Dick-a-da-dock-a-da-dick-a-da-dock-a-da. Triple-a-triple-a-triple-a-triple-a. One, a two, a one, two, three. As I said earlier, a minute ago, you can get a million different interpretations of how to do spang, spang-a-lang. For me, one of my favorites is to put a little emphasis on two and four. One of my favorite drummers, Jeff Hamilton, one of the first lessons I took when I moved to L.A. was with him. And we talked about all kinds of different ways to accent the ride cymbal. Elvin Jones on the and of two and then the and of four. Ding, ding, gagging. Two and four, ding, ding, gagging. Steve Houghton, one of my favorite teachers I've ever studied with and one of my favorite drummers, taught me a lot about Elvin Jones and accenting the and, ding, ding, gah, the third triplet, spang, spang-a-lang, spang, and that rolling triplet. As I said, lots and lots of interpretations. Right now, I'm going to play a two and four accent at a medium tempo with spang, spang-a-lang. Now, it's my interpretation and many of the teachers I've studied with's interpretation. In fact, Tony Williams, one of my favorite drummers of all time, I got a chance to study with him quite a bit before he passed away and at a young age not too long ago. But he often played ding, digga-ding, 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 digga-ding. And if you think about it, that's not really triplets. Triplets at that tempo, ding, 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 would be ding, 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 ding. When I heard Tony Williams playing with Miles Davis, I heard Tony Williams' ride cymbal sounding the same as Miles Davis's trumpet. So I'm going to play more what some drummers would call an eighth note at this fast tempo, but it's really, to me, it's just spang, spang-a-lang, it's just faster. I'm not gonna go tick, 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 and I'm not gonna go tick, 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 but I'm gonna play ding, 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 ding. Think music, think spang, spang-a-lang, spang-a-lang, and think about a bass line. Okay, now I'm gonna take spang, spang-a-lang, and I'm gonna lightly play four quarter notes with this. I'm not saying you've gotta feather your bass drum and play quarter notes. Some people will say, it's a must, you have to do this. Other people will say, no, I wanna do the Max Roach drop and bomb things. I wanna do the Tony Williams thing. I wanna play more the way Bill Stewart does it. You can go a million different ways on this, but right now, with this kit tuned the way it is, I'm gonna try to play lightly, with the felt side of the beater on the bass drum, lightly with the bass drum, quarter notes, with spang, spang-a-lang on the right hand, and two and four on the hi-hat at a slow tempo. One, a two, a one, two, three. Here's spang, spang-a-lang with bass drums on the quarter notes on the bass drum at a medium tempo. One, a two, a one, two, three. Here's spang, spang-a-lang in the right hand, two and four on the hi-hat, and the bass drum soft as possible. In an earlier lesson where I talked about quarter notes in the right hand, I stressed how important it is to make sure the ride cymbal is the number one instrument that you're playing in jazz. Whether you're playing spang, spang-a-lang, or spang-a-lang-a-lang-lang, or spang, spang, spang-a-lang, exercises we'll get into later, it's important to focus on that ride cymbal. I once had a teacher that said, if you're not staring at that ride cymbal, you're not focusing on it. I would look off into space, and I'd play every exercise I knew from every book I'd ever studied in. And he said, that doesn't sound like jazz. It doesn't sound like you're making music. It just sounds like you're playing a lot of exercises. When we talk about rock curriculum, when we talk about different styles, it's the same thing. Cuban drummers get very upset when you say, this is the songo beat. That's not the songo beat or the funk beat or the rock beat. It's a songo groove or a funk beat or a rock beat. Spang, spang-a-lang is a jazz ride cymbal pattern or idea or exercise. At the end of this lesson, I'm going to combine a lot of things and try to make a musical statement. But right now, I'm showing you exercises. So here is spang, spang-a-lang on an up-tempo with the ride cymbal and quarter notes feathered lightly with the bass drum. One, two, one, two, one, two, three. For those of you who haven't done that before, that's tricky. That's three-way independence, right? Ride cymbal, hi-hat, bass drum. Right hand, left hand, bass drum. Now it's going to get trickier. Let's do the same idea slow, but we're going to call this four-way independence. Now I'd like to play spang, spang-a-lang with my right hand, two and four with the hi-hat, and the and of two with the left hand at a slow tempo. One, two, one, two, three. Now I'd like to play that at a medium tempo. And at a fast tempo. now I'd like to play my bass drum on the end of two at a slow tempo with spang, spang, a lang in the right hand. Remember the ride cymbal is key, loudest, then hi-hat, bass drum, softer. Hi-hat next, bass drum, softer. One, a two, a one, two, three. Now at a medium tempo. Now at an up tempo. Now I'd like to play the snare drum on the end of four at a slow tempo. Now at a medium tempo. Now the snare drum on the end of four at an up tempo. Now I'd like to play the bass drum on the end of four at a slow tempo. A one, two, three. Next, I'd like to play the bass drum on the end of four at a medium tempo. Remember, I'm thinking bass line. Whatever I play with the snare drum and bass drum is like salt and pepper on the meat and potatoes of the ride cymbal. If you play snare drum way too loud, many rock drummers think, oh, I'm gonna play jazz. Shh. It's jazz. That's not the way that I, that might be some new kind of jazz that you're gonna come up with next week, and that's okay, you're breaking new ground, but to follow in the tradition of what started years and years and years ago in New Orleans, Louisiana, and went up the Mississippi to Chicago and became everything it is today, to do it, you gotta learn it right first before you can break the rules. So snare drum and bass drum, tom-toms, any extracurricular stuff, way down in the mix, salt and pepper on the ride cymbal and the hi-hat, which are meat and potatoes. So here is the and of four on the bass drum at an up-tempo. One, I'm going to think about the bass line. One, two, one, two, three. Now in other lessons, for the sake of independence, these are lessons, this is curriculum we're going to cover. Dang, dang, ka, dang, dang. Another very important ride cymbal pattern. We're going to cover dang, ka, dang, ka, dang, dang. We're going to cover dang, 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 ka, dang. And dang, 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 ka. These need to be covered because they're all different coordination exercises. They are exercises, but they're not meant to be thought of as music. You take those exercises, those vocabulary ideas, and you make them into music, and that's what I'm going to try to do right now at a medium tempo, or the different things I showed you, the different exercises I showed you in this lesson, I'm going to try to make music out of it. And all I'm really going to think about is all that's really going to be a given or a foundation is spang, spang, a lang in the right hand. The hi-hat's going to be on 2 and 4. In other lessons, we're going to cover the hi-hat playing maybe before 2. Do, chica, do, 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 do. Do, do, chica. We'll do all kinds of different things. The basic meat and potatoes here is 2 and 4 on the hi-hat, spang-a-lang on the ride cymbal, and I'm going to improvise with the snare drum and bass drum. The one other element I want to add in here is a crush roll with the left hand, like this. Whether you're playing match grip, Bill Stewart plays match grip all the time when he plays jazz. He sure sounds authentic to me. So nothing wrong with playing jazz match grip, playing match traditional grip. Stevie Wonder held his sticks like this when he played drums on lots of his solo albums early on. I don't think anybody said when they listened to the records, gee, it doesn't sound like Stevie's holding his sticks the right way. It just sounded really good. So here I go. I'm gonna maybe play traditional, maybe play matched, but I'm gonna do a crush roll with the left hand on the end of 2 sometimes, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe on the end of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe there'll be long crush rolls like this. 1, 2, 3. Maybe they'll be short like this. That's where it becomes improvisation and jazz. That's what I'm going to try to do right now. Take these exercises I've shown you. Unfortunately, I can't do a crush roll with my bass drum. Or maybe somebody can. I hope they can, and I hope they do. I want to hear it. That's what's exciting about jazz, is that you're always improvising, coming up with new things. That's what is exciting about any style of music. But here we go at a medium tempo, spang, spang, a lang on the right hand, 2 and 4 on the hi-hat, throwing all these other elements in quietly so that they don't get in the way of the ride cymbal, which is playing along, most importantly, with the boom, boom, doom, 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 boom, boom. Boom, boom. I'll go medium. Boom, 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 doom, 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 doom. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. We'll get into more complicated ideas. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-um. The Jim Chapin book has all kinds of ba 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 bo ba bo ba boom ba ba bo ba boom ba oop ba oop ba oom ba bo ba ga da ga do go ba. We'll get into some of these other ideas for our curriculum because it's very, very important to get this independence going. These are the ideas I'd like you to practice with. I'm going to play 8 bars of each one. There's 6 of them. And I'm going to play them, unlike the first lesson, which was quarter notes, I'm going to play them with spang, spang, a lang, and the ride cymbal. Here we go. The first one will be just ride cymbal and hi-hat. Number 2, spang, spang, a lang with quarter notes on the bass drum. Remember, soft on the bass drum, loud on the ride cymbal. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Number 3, end of 2 on the snare drum, spang, spang, a lang on the right hand, 2 and 4 on the hi hat. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Number 4, end of 2 on the bass drum with spang, spang, a lang on the ride cymbal. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. I went a little long because it was fun. You can't stop when you play these. Now, number five is going to be and a four with the snare drum. Spang, spang, a lang, and the ride cymbal. And the last one is going to be and a four and the bass drum with spang, spang, a lang, and the right hand. Can't stop. As I said earlier, it's you just can't stop. You get playing. The one thing I'm doing now, different at 48 than I did at 8 when I first learned these, I didn't play them for that long. I just played them enough to get it down, to get my lesson under control, to pass my lesson for that week. Now I'm playing them because I'm thinking of the bass line. So I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. I hope these exercises work for you. And remember, think music first. These are exercises, but keep the bass line in your head, and later the piano and the guitar and all the other horns and everything, vocals. But right now, make music out of these with your vocabulary exercises. See you on the next lesson. Thanks.